the other person we're going to talk about here, Top Gun, broke all the records. Final numbers came in. Tom Cruise has never talked about climate change, and that's why I love. I don't know what goes on behind the scenes, and I know I did an uncircled show on Patreon about how I'm joining Scientology after seeing Top Gun 2. But you never hear any bullshit out of this guy regarding anything else, like climate change, BLM. He's never had he doesn't have a Ukraine flag. I don't even think Tom Cruise has social media.
He's a Scientologist.
Yeah. Correct, but he does that in private.
He doesn't talk about it.
Yeah, he never talks about it.
Which I love.
You can't. You have to stay quiet.
Yes.
When you have slaves.
Yes. 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 And he does it.
Yet
quite
another reason
well.
For me to join, Bob.
He does it quite.
You know how much
lightly.
You know how much more shit I could pump out if I had slaves.
And by the way, he doesn't care.
White or black. I don't care what color the slaves are. I just need actual slaves.
Yeah, they're not sorting by color in Scientology.
I'm not
that
doing
I'm
race.
Aware of.
No, they're not doing it by race over there. By matter of fact, most of the white people are the
really
slaves
white
there.
Over
yeah, it is.
There.
Yeah. It is. It was a friend of mine's mom, and they were like, man, I haven't talked to my mom in years. I was like, what happened? She was in Scientology, whatever. And I was like, when's the last time you saw her? And it was like 12 years ago. I was like, what was she doing? He said she was scrubbing the floors upstairs for $27,000 a year, but like hands and knees type shit.
She
and
must
I was
have
like,
been
fuck.
A Sea Org. What is it? Sea Org?
The Sea Org is when you go into the ships. So
okay,
that's
okay,
when,
okay.
Like, you,
maybe
you're saying, I don't want to scrub for $27,000 a year. Well, now you're going to clean toilets with a toothbrush for pennies a year because technically you're on international waters and you're no longer an American. You belong to Scientology.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't care. What, yes.
Had
I don't
figure it out.
I don't care what race the slaves are. I don't.
Sure.
I really want to make that clear.
No. And we heard you on that.
I just need them. I just need them. Okay.
Yeah. No.
I could pump out probably 5 more shows a week.
Sure.
If I had them.
What would.
You know.
How would that?
Just to do the rest of the shit.
Oh,
make this, call the lawyer.
Sure.
You're my legal guardian for the signatures on this. Go talk to the other fucking people about shit. Like all of that. And then I could probably, I could probably pump out like 5-6 more shows a week. Easily.
Yeah.
Easily.
Yeah.
I've got that mapped out too. Monday through Friday sports, bump up RPR and bump up 2 more in Cirque. Good to go. But I need slaves for that.
You're describing an assistant. We could hire one of those.
No, no. Because
you
still,
assistants.
All of this shit still requires your signature, your fucking wet signature, your thing. Mm-hmm. And it's just like, no, I don't want, for the bank accounts, you have to be there in person. No, dude, that's 3 hours out of my life to
we
deal
also,
with your bullshit.
I mean, we're entitled to our 15-minute smoke break every hour.
Yeah.
Yes.
You have to. You have to.
Shouts to Lucy.
And by the way, Scientology, for what it's worth, they're really just doing internships, but on a universal scale. I mean, they're signing billion-year contracts, right?
Yeah.
So whereas you might be an intern for 2 years in college, these people have to be an intern for, you know, like 100 million years.
100 million
years. But they're on a billion-year life cycle.
And we're not.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
And Tom
we're only
Cruise
live
doesn't
for 80.
Care about environment or Ukraine or anything because the spaceship is coming, right?
Eventually.
And
eventually.
It will scoop him up. So like this world, he does not, you know, he's going to get what he needs from it,
right.
And then be beamed up.
Yeah,
you're not going to hear him talk about any issues.
Probably not, right?
In this life.
It's great.
Yeah.
And that's why he's breaking all the records. We'll just chat briefly about it because we talked about it on Drinking Bros. One, the movie's fucking awesome. Two, this is Tom Cruise's first opening over $100 million, which was shocking to me. I was like, really? Tom Cruise? First movie over $100 million for the weekend. That's
I
true.
Guess, I mean, when was his last,
Yeah. Crazy, right?
Yeah.
But if you haven't seen it, go see it. Highly recommend IMAX. That's the first time I think I've ever said that, where it blows your face off. When they hit the jets and all that shit, you're fucking in it. And, and God bless that guy. It's amazing. But while one star is rising, Jesse, another one is falling.
Oh.
Chatted about Tom Hanks when you were gone and the accent in Elvis that he is in a different movie. That is not the one that he should be in.
You really think that Baz Luhrmann was like...
I don't think Baz Luhrmann had a choice.
He was scared to say something
to Tom Hanks. Really? Two-time Oscar winner Tom Hanks, who probably, in all sincerity, should have been 3-time. I think he should have won for Castaway. And that should have been 3 years in a row. That should have been 3 years in a row for Tom Hanks.
Who won
for
against
sure.
him? Do you remember?
I don't remember the Castaway year.
Castaway was 2000?
Yeah.
Oh, I know who won.
Who won?
Oh.
Russell Crowe for Gladiator.
Oh, Lord.
Are you not entertained?
I love. Look,
no,
I loved
true. He
I loved Gladiator, but But if you're giving away an Oscar in that movie, it should have been Joaquin Phoenix.
And also, I mean, say that that was a makeup Oscar for him not getting it for the cigarette movie with Al Pacino.
Confidential.
No.
L.A. Confidential?
No. It was like, not Inside Man, but it was The Insider.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Yes, it is. And same way. By the way, the next year after that was Denzel for Training Day. And Denzel should have got it that the year before for Hurricane. And it was just like, yeah, whatever, man. But Castaway, that should have been a three-peat for him. And it wasn't. Now he's got this unfortunate turn in Elvis, which everybody's like, oh, what the fuck is this, man? Like,
is everyone not liking it?
Everyone. Oh. And everybody's saying the rest of the movie is great, but his performance, Tom Hanks, is so polarizing that people just turn the fuck off by it. We'll see what happens with it.
Yeah.
But they're starting to cut him out of the trailers as this keeps going along.
Yeah.
And they're, by the way, if you don't think Hollywood's recutting new ones, they are. This little spat with China and Taiwan, in the Top Gun trailer, the new one that just magically got released, he's got the Taiwan patches back on the jacket and everything. So something happened. I don't know what it was.
Okay.
Maybe it was the opening box office, but they definitely told China to fuck off on that. With this, they're editing his character out of these upcoming trailers with Elvis.
Okay.
And focusing more on the kid, which they probably should. And then today, got some unfortunate news about Tommy. And I love Tom Hanks.
Right.
But he starred in that movie, a live-action version of Pinocchio.
I was about to say, does he
$150 million, and they pushed it to streaming today. So, strange. That is a big boy movie. And, like, I would have taken my kids for sure to see Pinocchio. So, I don't know what happened. You can pull him up. I mean, he's doing another bit. He looks like the uncle in...
He's definitely not unrecognizable, guys. Unless, is he Pinocchio? Oh, okay. Yeah. No, that is...
He twained it. That is a little Mark Twain, dude.
That is how Tom Hanks should always look from now on. Because he, like, collects typewriters. He's, like, a total weirdo. He needs to look like that.
Yeah.
But, oh, bummer.
Yeah.
This looks cute.
Is this a Disney Plus flex?
Oh, maybe it is Disney going Plus. To Disney Plus.
No, it is. Oh. And they own a movie, but like...
So that's what I'm saying.
At this point, seeing what Netflix is going through, because they're putting Knives Out and the rest of their movies into theaters. Pardon me, the expensive ones, right? Why wouldn't you do this looking at this weekend's box office totals? Clearly, it's back. People just want to see something good. Pinocchio with Tom Hanks in a PG movie... would have done it. Like, I would have brought my kids to that for sure.
Yeah. And it looks
so cute. Why skip theaters for that? It seems strange. Unless he did something weird again.
They're flexing. They're flexing. Because Disney Maybe. Plus is like, oh, you have to put your movies in theaters because you, Poe?
Yeah.
We ain't Poe.
Yeah.
We'll put it wherever we want. This Tom Hanks movie, this Tom Hanks fucking movie, fuck you.
Yeah.
We'll just put it on streaming. We can do whatever we want.
It's crazy. $150 million. Fuck it, streaming.
Dang.
And there's a big cast in that. Like Keegan-Michael Key is in it. There's a bunch of cool people.
I think Robert Downey Jr. maybe.
He might
really?
Be. Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah. And you're just going to slide that over to streaming.
Maybe it's not good.
That's the thing. That's the speculation right now. So I'm not real sure. And I got even moved by the poster.
Yeah.
It's just Pinocchio and there's no strings. So he's a real boy. And that fucking... really rung me out this morning.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah. Well, you've been emotional lately.
Yeah. Well, I just had a baby.
Yeah, you just had a baby, so your hormones are just going a little bit crazy. But
you
is a fucking Robert Zemeckis movie. Too.
Yes.
So you got Zemeckis, and then
something must
Zemeckis
have
did Castaway. He did Forrest Gump.
Something must
he did
have
fucking
happened.
Back to the Future.
He's done everything. It's Robert Zemeckis. He did Polar Express for Christ's sakes, which was. Polar Express won the Oscar for Best Animated Picture.
I hope not, because that's literally the definition of the Uncanny Valley.
Yeah, I hate
it creeps
that movie.
Me out.
Yeah, I don't mind it. I watched it. It's not bad.
So you got Joseph Gordon-Levitt.
That's right, Joseph Gordon-Levitt.
Jiminy Cricket.
Pinocchio. Pinocchio.
Who is
Pinocchio? Is he Pinocchio when he's a real boy?
Yeah, no.
Jason Gordon-Levitt.
That's perfect casting. If he fucking... pops off of those strings, and then he starts running down the street, and it's Joseph Gordon-Levitt. That's perfect casting.
It's a serial killer child.
Oh God,
right.
Damn it.
Whoa.
Who is that, Bob?
Benjamin Evan Ainsworth.
Oh yeah, of course. I know he's a
what?
He is gonna be it with a name like that.
Yep. When you're going by three names already as a kid, you're shooting up a school.
No, he's just gonna be a little douchey. Don't you think?
Who knows?
Yeah, this is like Benjamin Evan Ainsworth, like caught like puking up Molly outside of a club in L.A. like in 10 years.
You only...
Well, but he was in that Pinocchio movie as a child.
He was Pinocchio.
It's hard to get away from that child actor.
He felt like he could never lie. And then boom, he fucking offs himself.
Yeah.